वेलकम टू माय चैनल महेंद्र यमी एनआईटी। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कवर द टॉपिक हीट एंड मास ट्रांसफर। इन थर्मोडायनेमिक व्हाट हैपन अकॉर्डिंग टू द सेकंड लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स एंड फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स व्हाट वी टॉक अबाउट and what we left which is not covered in thermodynamic. So heat and mass heat transfer concept is required. Definition of heat and mass transfer. Heat transfer, flow of energy due solely to a temperature difference. From second law of thermodynamics, spontaneous heat flow in the direction of decreasing temperature. From high temperature to low temperature, heat flows according to the second law of thermodynamics. But at which rate heat will flow? It is not covered in the thermodynamics. Heat energy can be transported through a solid, liquid, gas or vacuum. Mass transfer. Mass transfer is the net movement of mass from one location to another location. Mass transfer is mainly happen due to concentration difference. If in some portion concentration is high and some portion is concentration is low, then region of high concentration to lower concentration mass transfer will occur. You can see in the figure, this is our thermal container T, and here I am heating, then heat is transferring due to conduction, convection and radiation. There are three modes of heat transfer. Mass transfer, evaporation of water from a pond to the atmosphere. From high concentration to low concentration mass transfer occur. Mode of heat transfer. Heat can be transferred in three different modes: conduction, convection and radiation. What is conduction, what is convection and what is radiation? I am going to talk about in the detail. As you can see in the figure, there is a one stove which is heating on the induction heater. Heat is transferring through the conduction mode, convection mode and radiation mode. To conduction, the heat is transferred from the more energetic particle of a substance to the adjacent less energy as a result of interaction between the particle. In solid, heat transfer mainly occur due to movement of free electron, lattice movement, combination of vibration of the molecule in a lattice and the energy transport by the free electron. Example, solid in metallic form. In gases and liquid, conduction is due to the collision and diffusion of the molecule during their random motion. And one thing I am going to talk about, the diamond. Diamond is a non-metal, but its thermal conductivity is very high. So what are the concepts behind the thermal conductivity of the diamond? In diamond, there is a free electron is not available, but due to lattice vibration, heat is conducted in the diamond. The diamond thermal conductivity is 2300 watt per meter Kelvin. If we are going to talk about the thermal conductivity of different material, डायमंड इज द हाईएस्ट, सिल्वर इज द सेकेंड हाईएस्ट 405 वाट पर मीटर केल्विन, कॉपर 385, गोल्ड 319, एल्युमिनियम 200, स्टील 15 to 35 वाट पर मीटर केल्विन, मरकरी 8 वाट पर मीटर केल्विन, ग्लास 1.2 वाट पर मीटर केल्विन, एयर बेरिलस 0.024 वाट पर मीटर केल्विन। तो एयर इज यूज एज इंसुलेशन, एंड फ्रॉन 12 इज मोस्ट 0.0083 लोएस्ट। थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी, तो इन सॉलिड हीट इज कंडक्टेड बाय टू मैकेनिज्म, वन इज द लैटिस वाइब्रेशन लिक्विड एंड गैसेस। हीट इज कंडक्टेड बाई टू मैकेनिज्म, कोलिजन एंड डिफ्यूजन। इन केस ऑफ गैसेज द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ हीट कंडक्शन इज सिंपल। द काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ ए मॉलिक्यूल इज ए फंक्शन ऑफ टेम्परेचर। द काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूल इज ड्यू टू दियर रेंडम ट्रांसलेशनल मोशन एज वेल एज दियर वाइब्रेशनल एंड रोटेशनल मोशन। दीज मॉलिक्यूल्स आर इन कंटिन्यूअस रेंडम मोशन एक्सचेंजिंग एनर्जी एंड मोमेंटम। When a molecule from the high temperature region collide with a molecule from the low temperature region, it loses energy by collision. Liquids, in liquids the mechanism of heat is nearer to the gas. However, the molecules are more closely spaced and intermolecular forces come into play. These are all about the conduction. And there is a Fourier law of heat conduction. The rate of heat conduction through a medium depends on the geometry of the medium, its thickness and material of the medium, as well as temperature across the medium. So suppose you are taking a slab which is having the thickness delta x and the temperature at one layer is T1 and another layer is T2 and a cross area is the A. Then heat transfer is directly proportional to the area temperature difference and inversely proportional to the thickness along which the heat transfer it took place. The heat transfer along which thickness is took place is the length and perpendicular cross section. The cross sectional area it is directly proportional and thickness it is indirectly proportional. Then formula came into the Q is equal to Ka dT by dx. dT by dx is the temperature gradient. Here is the thermal conductivity of the different material. Diamond is the highest. As I have earlier said that diamond is having around 2300. After that silver, copper, and the air is lowest 0.024. Diamond thermal conductivity is very high, perfect heat sink example for high power laser diode. Air is very low, good insulator, home insulation, woolen clothing, window double glazing, metal good conductor, electron transfer energy from hot to cold. Next is the convection. In convection what happen? The mode of energy transfer between a solid surface and adjacent liquid or gases, and it involves the combined effect of conduction and fluid motion. So there are two types of convection: natural convection and forced convection. So what happen in natural convection? As we know that ki density, the due to density difference the convection happen. If temperature rises of one layer, then its density goes down and heat flows, and due to this density difference molecules movement occurs and molecule move from the high density to low density. Natural convection, fluid motion occurs due to density variation caused by the temperature difference. Due to temperature difference, there is in the density variation, and due to this, फ्लूइड मोशन अकर, फोर्स कन्वेक्शन, फ्लूइड मोशन कॉज्ड बाय एन एक्सटर्नल एजेंसी, न्यूटन्स लॉ ऑफ कूलिंग, देयर इज ए न्यूटन्स लॉ, अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस कन्वेक्शन हीट ट्रांसफर इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द सरफेस एरिया थ्रू हिच कन्वेक्शन हीट ट्रांसफर टेक प्लेस एंड टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस इन द सरफेस टेम्परेचर एंड द एम्बियंट टेम्परेचर सरफेस एंड देन देयर इज ए कॉन्स्टेंट कोफिशियंट केम इन टू द पिक्चर कन्वेक्शन हीट ट्रांसफर कोफिशियंट एंड इट्स यूनिट इज वाट पर मीटर स्क्वायर डिग्री सेल्सियस. Radiation. The radiation is the third mode of heat transfer. It takes place in the form of electromagnetic waves as a result of the change in electronic configuration of the atom or molecule. As in conduction and convection, the transfer of heat requires medium. But in radiation, the presence of intermingling medium is not required. From the sun to the earth, heat is transferred due to this mode, that is radiation. Heat transfer by radiation is the fastest and it suffers no attenuation in a vacuum. This is how the energy of the sun reaches to the earth. Application on radiation heat transfer. In heat transfer study, we are interested in thermal radiation, which is the form of radiation emitted by bodies because of their temperature difference. So here in the radiation, there is a Stefan Boltzmann's law. So radiation heat transfer is directly proportional to the temperature to the power 4. Temperature to the power 4 and surface area. And there is a constant, Stefan Boltzmann constant. Stefan Boltzmann constant value is 5.67 into 10 to the power minus 8. This unit is watt per meter square per Kelvin to the power 4. And there is some question you should think. This is very important in the heat transfer. Why are fireplace poker made of iron and not copper? Some aluminium have air which is composed of solid tubular strand, while other have hollow air filled tube. Where could one more likely find the latter animal, in cold climate or warm? Two different material at the same temperature have different emissivity. Which one glows the brightest? Steel reinforcement bars add stability to concrete wall. Do they also enhance the insulating value of concrete? Should you lower the blinds and draw the curtains on a hot day? When one steps from a shower on a cold morning, why does the tile floor seem so much colder than air? These are the some questions you should think. Why do people become flushed over when overheated? So that's all about the simple conduction, convection and radiation. By showing another slide, I am going to show you the more about the conduction, convection and radiation before going into the much detail of the things, because these things is very important. Here we will cover all these things in detail. So here is the objective, how we are going to learn the heat and mass transfer. Understand how thermodynamics and heat transfer are related to each other. Distinguish thermal energy from other forms of energy and heat transfer from other forms of energy transfer. Perform general energy balance as well as surface energy balance. Understand the basic mechanism of heat transfer, which are conduction, convection and radiation, and Fourier law of heat conduction, Newton's law of cooling and Stefan Boltzmann law of radiation. Identify the mechanism of heat transfer that occurs simultaneously in practice. develop an awareness of the cost associated with heat losses, solve various heat transfer problems encountered in practice. So these are the things which we'll cover in heat and mass transfer in detail. So this is the thermodynamics and heat transfer. What left in the thermodynamics, which is going to cover in the heat and mass transfer. Heat is the form of energy that can be transferred from one system to another as a result of temperature difference. Thermodynamic is concerned with the amount of heat transfer as a system undergoes a process from one equilibrium state to another. This is the thermodynamics. Amount of heat transfer system undergoes from one process to another, from one state to another during the process. So this is the thermodynamic concern. Thermodynamics is concerned with the amount of heat transfer as a system undergoes a process from one equilibrium state to another equilibrium state. Heat transfer deal with the determination of the rate of such energy transfer as well as variation of temperature. The transfer of energy as heat is always from the higher temperature medium to lower temperature one. Heat transfer stops when the two medium reach the same temperature. Heat can be transferred in three different modes: conduction, convection, radiation. Difference between thermodynamic and heat transfer. Thermodynamic tells us how much heat is transferred, how much work is done, final state of the system. Heat transfer tells how, what is the mode of heat transfer, at what heat will be transferred, temperature distribution inside the system. There is some example. It is a thermos bottle. Here we are providing the insulation. It is inside the bottle. Hot coffee in the thermos bottle to cool to a certain temperature which cannot be determined by thermodynamic analysis. From the thermodynamics, you cannot say what will be the time, how long it to take for the hot coffee in a thermos bottle to cool to a certain temperature. So here, heat and mass transfer concept will require. Second, the hot coffee at 70 degrees Celsius and environment at 20 degrees Celsius, heat flows in the direction of decreasing temperature. Application area of heat transfer. These are the. This is the system in the Megahill. This is a heating device. This is a mechanical component. It is a power plant where steam flow inside the pipe. This is a hollow pipe, and on the pipe insulation is provided so that steam at required superheated steam at required temperature can be transferred from one place to another, and we can place it at which place it is required. This is the refrigeration, cool air during the cool air by using duct in the central air conditioning system. So these are the transfer of heat. We provide the insulation so that heat transfer can be reduced. These are the some application area. Historical background. In the early 19th century, heat was thought to be an invisible fluid called the caloric that flows from warmer body to cooler body. Kinetic theory treat molecule as a tiny ball that are in motion and thus possess kinetic energy. The energy associated with the random motion of atom and molecule is known as heat. Caloric theory, heat is a fluid-like substance called the caloric that is a massless, colorless, odorless and tasteless substance that can be poured from one body into the another. Careful experiment of the Englishman James P. Joule, published in 1843, convinced the skeptics that heat was not a substance after all, and thus put the calorie theory to the rest. This is the scientist Joule, which discovered the Joule effect. This scientist is a British physicist born in Salford, England. Joule is best known for his work on the conversion of electrical and mechanical energy into the heat and the first law of thermodynamics. The energy unit Joule is named after him. The Joule's law of electric heating that he formulated states that the rate of heat production in a conducting wire is proportional to the product of resistance of the wire and square of the electric current. Q is equal to I square RT is his concept. Through his experiment, Joule has demonstrated the mechanical equivalence of heat, that is, the conversion of mechanical energy into an equivalent amount of thermal energy, which laid the foundation for the conversion of energy principle. Joule, together with William Thomson, later Lord Kelvin, discovered the temperature drop of a substance during pre-expansion, a phenomenon known as Joule-Thomas effect, which forms the foundation of the operation of the common vapor compression, refrigeration, and air conditioning system. These are about the main scientist's role in the heat and mass transfer, Joule. Energy engineering heat transfer. Heat transfer equipment such as heat exchanger, boiler, condenser, radiator, refrigerator, and solar collector are designed primarily on the basis of heat transfer. The heat transfer problem encountered in practice can be considered in two groups, rating and sizing problem. The rating problem deals with determination of heat transfer rate for an existing system at a specified temperature difference. The sizing problem deals with the determination of the size of the system in order to transfer heat at a specified rate for a specified temperature difference. An engineering device or process can be studied either experimentally or analytically. Testing and taking measurements by analysis or calculation. The experimental approach has the advantage that we deal with the actual physical system, and the desired quantity is determined by measurement within the limit of experimental error. However, this approach is expensive, time-consuming, and often impractical. The analytical approach has the advantage that it is fast and inexpensive, but the results obtained are subject to accuracy of the assumptions, approximation, and idealization made in the analysis. Modeling in engineering. Physical problem. Identify important variable. Apply relevant physical law. Make reasonable assumptions and approximation. A differential equation is generated. Apply applicable solution technique. Apply boundary and initial condition. That the solution of the problem. Mathematical modeling of physical problem. Here is a potato. Here is a water. Potato is inside the oven, and oven is at 170 degrees Celsius, 75. Modeling is a powerful engineering tool that provides great insight and simplicity at the expense of some accuracy. Heat and other forms of energy. Energy can exist in numerous forms such as thermal energy, mechanical energy, kinetic energy, potential energy, electrical energy, magnetic energy, chemical energy. There some constituents of the total energy of a system. The sum of all microscopic form of energy is called the internal energy. Internal energy may be viewed as sum of kinetic energy and potential energy. Sensible heat. The heat associated with the temperature change. If there is a temperature difference, then sensible heat will be transferred. And latent heat when phase change. When liquid 100 degrees Celsius water gets converted into 100 degrees Celsius into vapor, then the heat supplied is the latent heat. And when 0 degrees Celsius water gets converted into 0 degrees Celsius liquid, 0 degrees Celsius ice into 0 degrees Celsius water, then the amount of heat required is the latent heat. Latent heat of vaporization in the case of steam. and latent heat of freezing is the in case of ice. Nuclear energy, the internal energy associated with the bonds within the nucleus of atom itself. Internal energy and enthalpy. In the analysis of systems that involve fluid flow, we frequently encounter the combination of property U and PV. U is the internal energy, PV is the work done. The term PV represents the flow energy of the fluid. The internal energy U represents the microscopic energy of a non-flowing fluid, where enthalpy H represents the microscopic energy of a flowing fluid. Flowing fluid energy H, stationary fluid energy U. If the fluid is stationary, then internal energy will be in the picture. If this is non-flow, if the open system and flow is occurring, then enthalpy will come into the picture, which is the summation of U plus PV. Internal energy U represents the microscopic energy of a non-flowing fluid, where enthalpy H represents the microscopic energy of a flowing fluid. This is the concept of internal energy and enthalpy. Specific heat of gases, liquid and solid. Specific heat, the energy required to raise the temperature of a unit mass of a substance by 1 degree. Two kinds of specific heat, specific at constant volume, specific heat at constant pressure. The specific heat of a substance in general depends on two independent properties such as temperature and pressure. At low pressure and high temperature, all real gases approach ideal gas behavior, and therefore their specific heat depends on temperature only. This is a specific heat, 5 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Specific heat is the energy required to raise the temperature of a unit mass of a substance by 1 degree in a specified way. The specific heat of a substance changes with temperature. Incompressible substance, a substance whose specific volume does not change with temperature or pressure. The constant volume and constant pressure specific heat are identical for incompressible substance. The specific heat of incompressible substance depends on temperature only. Heat transfer, energy can be transferred from a given mass by two mechanisms, heat transfer and work. The first law of thermodynamics says about the conservation of energy. Energy cannot be created nor destroyed. It can only change the form. Energy balance for a closed system. Energy balance for a steady flow system. Surface energy balance. Conduction, convection and radiation, as I have earlier discussed, three mode of heat transfer. Heat can be transferred by using three mode: conduction, convection and radiation. You can see in the figure. Conduction happen in the solid region, convection in the liquid and radiation. There is no medium required. In liquid and gases, conduction also happen due to collision and momentum transfer, collision and diffusion. This is the convection, which is occurring in the fluid due to density difference arises from the temperature difference. Conduction, the transfer of heat or electric current from one substance to another by direct contact. Radiation, energy that is radiated or transmitted in the form of rays or waves or particle. The transfer of heat through a fluid caused by molecular momentum. This is the Fourier law of heat conduction. Q is equal to minus Ka dT by dx. In gases and liquid, conduction is due to collision and diffusion of molecules during their random motion. In solid, it is due to the combination of vibration of molecule in a lattice and the energy transport by free electron. This is the Fourier scientist. He was a French mathematician and physicist born in Auxerre, France. He is best known for his work on the infinite series of trigonometric functions and that bear his name and for his development of mathematical theory of heat conduction. Fourier established the partial differential equation governing heat diffusion and he solved it by using the Fourier series. The Fourier transfer, Fourier number and the Fourier law of heat conduction are named in his honor. Fourier is also credited with the discovery of phenomena of greenhouse effect in 1824. Thermal conductivity of different material is shown here. Diamond is 2300 and air is lowest 0.023. Urethane rigid form is also showing 0.026. This is the experimental setup to determine the thermal conductivity of the material. There is an electric heater and surrounding insulation is provided. Heat is transferring in only one direction. This is the sample material. Thermal conductivity of this material is K and the thickness is L and the, by knowing the heat transfer rate, the by using this formula LQ divided by A T1 minus T2, we can determine the value of K. The rate of heat transfer through a unit thickness of material per unit area per unit temperature difference. The thermal conductivity of a material is a measure of the ability of the material to conduct heat. A high value for thermal conductivity indicates that the material is a good heat conductor and low value indicates that material is a poor heat conductor or insulator. The range of thermal conductivity of various material at room temperature. The mechanism of heat conduction in different phases of a substance. Solid lattice vibration, flow of free electron, liquid molecular collision, molecular diffusion, gas molecular collision and molecular diffusion. Pure crystal and metal have the highest thermal conductivity and gases and insulating material are the lowest. This is the thermal conductivity of material varying with the temperature. As temperature rises from 0 to 10,000 Kelvin, the different materials' thermal conductivity varies. The variation of the thermal conductivity of various solid, liquid and gases with temperature. What is thermal diffusivity? Thermal diffusivity is nothing but it is the ratio of thermal conductivity divided by heat capacity, K divided by rho C. The thermal diffusivity alpha is equal to heat conduction divided by heat storage and its unit is meter square per second. A material that has a high thermal conductivity or a low heat capacity will obviously have a larger thermal diffusivity. The larger the thermal diffusivity, the faster the propagation of heat into the medium. A small value of thermal diffusivity means that heat is mostly absorbed by the material and a small amount of heat is conducted further. Convection here, heat transfer from a hot surface to air by convection. Here is air is flowing at ambient temperature. And this surface, this hot block is at the temperature of TS. Temperature variation of air. The mode of energy transfer between a solid surface and the adjacent liquid or gas that is in motion at it involves the combined effect of conduction and fluid motion. The faster the fluid motion, the greater the convection heat transfer. In the absence of any bulk fluid motion, heat transfer between a solid surface and the adjacent fluid is by pure conduction. Forced convection and natural convection. There is a blower is used for forced convection, the cooling of boiled egg by force and natural convection. If the fluid is forced to flow over the surface by external means such as fan, pump or wind, if the fluid motion is caused by buoyancy force that are induced by density difference due to the variation of temperature in the fluid. Heat transfer process that involves change of phase of a fluid are considered to be convection because of the fluid motion induced during the process, such as the rise of the vapor bubbles during boiling or the fall of the liquid droplets during condensation. Newton's law of cooling is used for convection heat transfer. There is a different convection heat transfer coefficient value. Free convection of gases having 2 to 25, free convection of liquid 10 to 1000, forced convection of gases 25 to 250, forced convection of liquid 50 to 20,000, and boiling and conduction 2500 to 1 lakh. The convection heat transfer coefficient H is not a property of the fluid. It is an experimentally determined parameter whose value depends on all the variables influencing convection, such as surface geometry, nature of fluid motion, the property of the fluid, the bulk fluid velocity. This is Isaac Newton, was an English mathematician, physicist and astronomer. Born in England, Newton is regarded as one of the greatest scientists and mathematicians in history. His contribution to mathematics include the development of binomial theorem, the differential calculus and integral calculus. He is said to have conceived the idea of law of gravity upon the observation of the fall of an apple in 1665. With the three fundamental laws that bear his name and are described in philosophy Naturalia Principia Mathematica, Newton is known as the father of classical mechanics. Newton showed that each of Kepler's three laws on the motion of planets and stars could be derived from the single law of gravity. Newton is also credited for the discovery of the composite nature of white light and the separation of different color by a prism. The law of cooling that governs the rate of heat transfer from a hot surface to cooler surrounding fluid is also attributed to the Newton. This is the radiation. Radiation is emitted by matter in the form of electromagnetic waves or photons as a result of the changes in the electronic configuration of the atom or molecule. Unlike conduction and convection, the transfer of heat by radiation does not require the presence of an intervening medium. The heat transfer by radiation is fastest and it suffers no attenuation in a vacuum. This is how the energy of the sun reaches the earth. In heat transfer studies, we are interested in thermal radiation, which is the form of radiation emitted by bodies because of their temperature. All bodies at a temperature above absolute zero emit thermal radiation. Radiation is a volumetric phenomena, and all solid, liquid, and gases emit, absorb, or transmit radiation to varying degree. Radiation is usually considered to be a surface phenomena for solids. Stefan Boltzmann's law, and it is a Stefan Boltzmann constant, 5.67 into 10 to the power minus 8 watt per meter square Kelvin to the power 4. Radiation emitted by real surfaces. Black body radiation represents the maximum amount of radiation that can be emitted from a surface at a specified temperature. There is a emissivity of some material at 300 Kelvin. Aluminium foil is having the emissivity of 0.07, anodized aluminium 0.82, water 0.9 C. Emissivity, a measure of how closely a surface approximates a black body for which epsilon is equal to 1. of the surface. There is a black body at the temperature of 400 Kelvin, and heat is transferred to the atmosphere is directly proportional to the T to the power 4, and its value is 1452 watt per meter square. वाट पर मीटर की पावर वाट पर मीटर स्क्वायर केल्विन की पावर 4. एब्जॉर्बिविटी द फ्रैक्शन ऑफ द रेडिएशन एनर्जी इंसिडेंट ऑन ए सरफेस दैट इज एब्जॉर्ब बाय ए सरफेस. ए ब्लैक बॉडी एब्जॉर्ब द एंटायर रेडिएशन दैट्स व्हाई हियर अल्फा इज इक्वल टू 1. द हीट हीट द एब्जॉर्बशन इफ इन एनी incident and energy is transferred on surface, then some heat will be absorbed and some will be reflected. Kirchhoff's law, the emissivity and the absorbivity of the surface at a given temperature and wavelength are equal. Emissivity is equal to epsilon and absorbivity is equal to alpha. Net radiation heat transfer, the difference between the rate of radiation emitted by the surface and radiation absorbed. The determination of the net rate of heat transfer by radiation between two surfaces is a complicated matter since it depends on the properties of the surface, their orientation relative to each other, the interaction of medium between the surfaces with radiation. Radiation is usually significant related to conduction or natural convection, but negligible related to the forced convection. When a surface is completely enclosed by a much larger surface at temperature, T surrounding separated by gas that does not intervene with radiation, the net rate of radiation heat transfer between these two surfaces is given by this formula. Simultaneous heat transfer mechanism. In radiation, there is no, if vacuum is there, then only one mode is radiation. If there is a mode is available, gas, then radiation, conduction or convection. If opaque solid, if it is a opaque solid, then only conduction. Prevention through design. The first of the fundamental canons of ethics for engineer is to hold paramount the safety, health and welfare of the public when fulfilling their professional duties. In 2007, the National Institute for Occupational Safety and Health launched the National Prevention Through Design Initiative with the mission to prevent or reduce work-related injuries, illness, and fatalities by including prevention consideration in all circumstances that impact individual in the workplace. Problem-solving technique. Engineering software package. A remark on signifying. These are the summary of today's lecture. That's all about. I am going to stop. If you did not subscribe my channel, please subscribe.